30 years ago, when the greatest issue in the world was apartheid in South Africa, Nelson Mandela and Desmond Tutu asked colleges, churches, so on, to sell their stock in companies that did business with the racist regime. And a lot of people did. And in the end, though it took a long struggle to get it done, it was an important part of South Africa's liberation. When Mandela got out of prison, he went straight to California to thank the students who had forced the sale of stock at 155 colleges around the U.S. This now is the great crisis in the planet. And so Desmond Tutu was one of the people who asked us to take up this weapon again, you know. And the logic is simple. These are not normal companies anymore. They're rogue companies. They have in their reserves about five times as much carbon as would be needed to take the planet past the 2-degree rise in temperature that everybody, even the U.S., has identified as the red line past which we can't go. That is to say, if they carry out their business plan, the planet tanks. And so many, many institutions and people are joining up to put this pressure on them by divestment. Maybe the most significant so far was in September when the Rockefeller family announced they were divesting, the first family of fossil fuel, the original oil fortune, saying we no longer think it's prudent or moral to hold on to these investments. To me, the day they did that, in a sense, was the beginning of the end of the fossil fuel age. The question is how quickly we can bring that end, whether it can happen quick enough to catch up with the physics of climate change or not.